I am going to walk through bulk actions in Workbench today. And to get started, you're going to start on the job list menu by clicking here. And then to select different jobs, there's a few different ways that you can do that. You can select a job and then click on Control, and that will select different jobs. You can also select Shift, and that will allow you to select multiple jobs. And then you may also drag across the different jobs that you want to select from bulk. And those are different ways that you can select jobs. Once you've selected the jobs that you want to do a bulk action on, you will right click, and then that will open this window of different options for you. As you can see, there are quite a few options of different things that you can do in bulk in Workbench now. The first one is execute. So if you click on execute, it will give you a window where you can see the jobs that will be affected. And then if any jobs will be affected, or if any jobs will be excluded, that will also be included in this list here. The reason any jobs would be excluded is if those jobs are currently running. So by clicking on continue, I can see that those are processing now, and my window will pop up. I'm going to minimize that for now, and then I can also click finish just to acknowledge that I've seen that message and those are currently executing. Now that all three of those have finished executing, I'm going to select, and then another option is preview. So if you select preview, the same thing will happen. You will see these jobs that have been selected, and then if you click continue, the window will pop up and you'll be able to see the jobs in preview mode as well. The next option is export. So if you want to export multiple jobs, this will automatically take you to export in Workbench with the jobs that you pre-selected. And from here, you simply just need to choose a location where you would want those, and then you would simply export the jobs there. The next option in bulk actions is bulk edit. And there are quite a few things that you can do from bulk edit. We'll start with edit job settings. And from here, you can edit any of the settings for all of these jobs. If you want to clear a field, for example, if I want to clear the domain or clear the username and password, I would simply select the checkbox without entering anything into those fields, and that tells Workbench that you want to clear those fields out. And I would click continue. Again, I would see the bulk change options, and then an option to automatically save jobs after bulk edit as well. I can also edit the job notifications. And I have some options here as well. I can either add to the existing notifications on these data sets. I can remove from the existing notifications on the data sets. I can replace all of the notifications, or I can clear all of the notifications as well. And then I would just update these as I like, with one of those selected, and then continue. The next option is to edit the provider settings. And all of these currently are Excel files that I have selected. But if I want to select some different options, it will show me different options for these. So for Excel files, I can see these are the different properties that I can edit. If I've selected different provider types, as you can see here, these two are Excel files and this job is in ODBC, and I decide that I want to bulk edit the provider settings, I'm going to have to choose which one I want to edit because these have different provider settings. So for this example, let's choose the ODBC connection provider. And you can see now I have different options because ODBC has different requirements. And so from there, I can just update credentials, the connection, and the string, etc. That would be the same for the reader settings. I can choose which one I want. Next, we can save. If I have multiple jobs that are in edited state, I can bulk save all of those at the same time. The next one is revert. So let's say that I have recently performed an action on data sets and I want to revert that. I can do that here by selecting those same data sets again and then reverting that action. The last thing I can do is delete the data sets. If I click on delete, it will tell me the data sets that are going to be deleted, as well as the ones that will be excluded. And I can delete from here as well. And those are the different options in bulk actions.